Yeah, I'll always be a metalhead. Nothing can take that away from me. Right. I mean, not jail, not people, not religion, not anything. I'll always be a metalhead. Metalhead.
You're listening to the Great Metal Debate Podcast.
Hey everyone, this is Red Iron here for the Great Metal Debate to share with you a review of We Are One, the new collaboration between UDO and the Bundeswehr Music Corps, the official concert band of the German Armed Forces. You may have seen UDO at Navy Metal Night in 2014 or Wacken in 2015, and if you enjoyed these performances, you'll love this new album that releases on July 17th from AFM Records and Soul Food Music. The UDO lineup is mostly intact since their most recent studio album, Steel Factory. 68-year-old Udo Dirkschneider is on vocals, bringing a refined touch and instinct he has developed over the course of 26 studio albums worth of experience. You of course know his gritty voice from accept classics such as Balls to the Wall and Fast as a Shark. The band has Andriy Smirnov and Fabian D. Demers on guitars, Tillen Hoodrap constantly standing out on bass, and Sven Dirkschneider, the son of Udo, behind the drum kit. But that's not all. This time they have around 60 friends along for the ride. The concert band of the German Armed Forces is the same orchestra that supported UDO at Naval Metal Night, and the joint effort of We Are One is the logical continuation. The album contains rock, metal, prog, ballads, and even some funkiness, all the while keeping a consistent tone and quality. There are 15 songs arranged by UDO together with Christoph Schiebling, with songwriting contributions from two former Accept members, Stefan Kaufmann and Peter Baltz. Composers Guido Rinnert and Alexander Ruber helped this to be one of the most energetic fusions of rock and orchestra I've heard. We Are One has more life flowing through it than most contemporary performances, like the Scorpions playing with the Berlin Philharmonic, and at no point will you feel like the rock band is being restrained to stay in time with the orchestral element. This isn't quite Metallica S&M, but it takes the same approach, treating the orchestra and choirs as a part of the music that has always been there, as opposed to just a supporting role. When you tell me I'm going to listen to a rock metal album with orchestration, I kind of assume I've heard it before, but We Are One was filled with new sounds. The lyrical themes deal with problems the world is currently facing, ranging from pollution to politics, and even cyber insanity. I recently saw someone online get roasted for demanding, "Keep politics out of punk!" So remember that music is always a platform for a strong message. Be prepared to encounter lyrics in We Are One against protectionism, nationalism, and against the right wing. This isn't exactly Rage Against the Machine, but we do get a song about Greta Thunberg, so that's fun. Upon first listen, you will grasp the 100% intentional message of the lyrics. It boils down to take care of each other, pay attention to the world around you, and remember that we are all in this together. Imagine if Hearing Aid's Stars was a full-length album and not just a single. The words of We Are One are honest but optimistic, with not many moments of anger at the current situation, but instead hope for what we can do if we cooperate. During my first journey through the album, I found lots of fun material, well put together from all angles. We Are One is filled with strong moments and a variety of sounds. It's much better than most orchestra rock fusions, and the production of the recording is solid and clear. My two favorite tracks are numbers 4 and 14. The Future Is the Reason Why is about climate change, but I'm all about the music here. This is the military vibe I was expecting. It's a march of sorts with groovy riffage over drummer boy snares and flutes. Sabaton has some competition. The orchestra and choirs are highlighted here instead of simply supplementing Udo vocals, and it would be awesome live chanting, "Hey, hey, hey." The other song you can't miss is We Strike Back, near the end of the album. It's the shortest of the songs that isn't an instrumental and is undeniably metal metal. A growling intro and a tempo that is thrashier than the preceding songs, it almost has Aces High moments, but with strings and horns. I'm a sucker for a fast rocker, and will probably overplay this upbeat song in the car. The positives across We Are One's hour and 15 minutes are abundant. The guitar solos are spectacular, fantastic in tone and how they fit into each song. The bass lines frequently have my attention, not just there to round out the sound, but to motivate the music. Every single song has something unique to offer. The orchestra isn't just mimicking the music of a rock band, they are utilized as their own element, another tool and another layer to convey feelings. There's a ton of energy to this album, and they pack the whole disc with maximum music. On the flip side, the choir can be a bit ridiculous and sometimes changes the tone of a song into a heal the world vibe. I'm also curious what We Are One would sound like if Udo's voice was 20 years younger. A bit of a low point, track 13, Here We Go Again, is just out there. If it were the only song I'd heard, I wouldn't seek out anymore. This song about worldwide refugee movements is enjoyable at the start. The band brings some nasty funk that reminds me of late-era Deep Purple. Think Lick It Up from Battle Rages On. But then, it's kind of a rap, This is the only track that's lost on me, finally crossing the silliness line that heavy metal so often flirts with. It's surprising that Udo himself seems to be less of a focus in the third quarter, but that allows other aspects of the joint effort to shine. We Are One is definitely not an ego album, which is great. The first thing I'll do when I have a physical copy in my hands, with complete liner notes, is read who the other soloing vocalists are alongside Udo, because they are truly awesome. We Are One is releasing in many formats, so you'll have options. There's digital, a regular CD, a CD packaged with the Blu-ray, and four different colors of 12-inch double vinyls. Live, this album could be presented in many ways. A sit-down arena show, an outdoor amphitheater at a festival, or even a smaller stage at a local venue. It would be an immensely powerful experience, as the album is built with a military drive. Four shows were planned, but with the current state of live music, these may be something to look forward to later. Again, I haven't heard this much live from rock orchestration since Concerto for Group and Orchestra in 1969, although that one still remains at the top. Some parts of We Are One seem like they're from another era, like the early 90s maybe? The melodic choruses delivered by the choir are sometimes a surprise, as in the title track, but it's a cool album with a lot going on. Power metal fans and arena rock fans need to hear this album. If you don't want to have politics in your music, steer clear. When these songs come up on shuffle, I'm not going to skip them. They're all solid, though they may raise the eyebrows of an unsuspecting passenger. These tracks don't drain me like some military power metal tends to do, so if you've got an hour drive ahead of you, throw We Are One on in the car. That's it for me, Red Iron, on this one for the Great Metal Debate. Be seeing you.